is safe in your home. Okay? Yes. Shall we move to our class? Today we discuss about very important topic, that is the heart. Okay. You know that heart is the pumping organ in our circulatory system. Okay, what is heart? Yes, heart is a muscular organ and it's situated in the left side of in between two lungs, in behind the sternum in the thoracic cavity. Okay, the size of human heart is equal to 1 fist. The human size of human heart is equal to the size of 1 fist. Okay, next let's move to the longitudinal section of heart. The heart is covered by a double membrane covering called the pericardium. A membranous cover called pericardium. And even the pericardium, a pericardial fluid is seen. A pericardial fluid in between the pericardial membrane. The pericardial fluid which helps to reduce friction when the heart is pumped. The pericardial fluid which helps to the reduce friction in between the membrane when the heart is pumped. Okay, this is the longitudinal section of heart. Can we move to the structure of the heart? The heart contains 4 chambers. The above is atria and below is ventricles. Heart contains 2 atria and 2 ventricles. Okay, this is the right atrium. This is right ventricle. This is the left atrium. Left atrium, and it is the left ventricle. Okay, heart contains 4 chambers, 2 atriums and 2 ventricles. Then the heart contains 2 valves. These tricuspid valve. Tricuspid valve. And this is bicuspid valve. This is all about the chambers and valves. And heart have many arteries and veins which help to the circulation of blood. So the arteries are, this is the main artery, aorta. And this is pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery. Okay, this is are the 2 arteries seen in heart, aorta and pulmonary artery. And these are the veins which seen in the heart. There are superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Superior vena cava and inferior vena cava, and also here the pulmonary veins. Pulmonary veins. Okay, this is all about the structure of heart. 4 chambers, 2 atriums and 2 ventricles. In between the atrium and ventricle, there are 2 types of valves are seen, bicuspid valve and tricuspid valve.
And for the blood circulation, heart contains arteries and veins, the aorta and pulmonary artery, pulmonary veins and superior and inferior vena cava. This is all about the structure of our human heart. Okay, then we move to the function of this heart. How the heart is function? Okay. Here, the lungs contain oxygen molecule. So the blood carry oxygen, so that we called oxygenated blood. The pulmonary veins, you know that the veins, in previous class we studied that veins which carry the deoxygenated blood. But in the case of heart, pulmonary veins which carry oxygenated blood from lungs. Okay, the pulmonary veins which carry oxygenated blood to heart. The pulmonary veins carry blood for oxygenated blood from lungs to the heart. The first part is left atrium. Okay, when the heart, left atrium fill with blood, it contract and the blood pass through the left ventricle. Okay, the atrium give the blood to left pulmonary veins gives to the blood to left atrium. The blood reach to the left ventricle. The atrium contract, the blood flow to the ventricles. That time the atrium relax and the blood fill with ventricles. Okay, the backward flow is doesn't occur because here have a valve called bicuspid valve. Okay, then here the blood is filled. When the ventricle contract, the blood is moved to the aorta. Okay, here the ventricle is contract, the blood moved to the aorta. Okay, through aorta the blood which move out to the different organs. Okay, the oxygenated blood carry to the aorta to move different organs in our body. Then the organ, from this organ the blood is the cells of the organ which absorb the oxygenated blood and become the blood reach the then the blood become deoxygenated. Okay, the deoxygenated blood come to the deoxygenated blood come to the heart through the superior and inferior vena cava. The deoxygenated blood come to the superior and inferior vena cava. They reach to the right atrium. So now the right atrium fill with deoxygenated blood, isn't it? Okay, the deoxygenated blood which fill with the left right atrium, it pass the blood to the right ventricle. The right atrium contract and the blood flow to the right ventricle through the valve, tricuspid valve. Then the right atrium is relaxed and the right ventricle is filled with blood. And the blood which, when the right ventricle is contract, the blood is pumped to the pulmonary artery. Okay, the blood which pumped to the pulmonary artery and they move to the lungs for purification. So the deoxygenated blood move to the pulmonary artery to lungs. This is all about the circulation. You know that it's a double circulation. I will show you in simple way. Simple way, we say that this is the heart, the four chamber, atriums and ventricles. Okay, the above part is lungs and the below part is the body organs. Okay, when the oxygenated blood reaches to the atrium through pulmonary veins, okay, the atrium is contract, the blood move to the ventricle through bicuspid valves. Then the ventricles the pass to the blood to aorta to the body organs. The body organs which carry deoxygenated blood to the atrium through the superior and inferior vena cava. Then the atrium is contract, the blood flow to the ventricles and through the tricuspid valves. When the ventricle is contract, the blood moves to the lungs through the pulmonary arteries. This about the function of heart. The circulation is two type. There are pulmonary circulation and the systemic circulation. The circulation the two type, pulmonary circulation and systemic circulation. Systemic, that we discussed about in our previous class. Okay, this about today's. I hope all of you understood this. Okay, have a nice day. Thank you all.